memorize, understand the concepts. Understand the concepts.
Loved it. 100% roast. Don't memorize.
You have to understand the concept.
Understand the concept.
Anand just cleared PMP like 10 minutes ago. Ali have cleared PMP with above target. Congratulations, Raheel, on clearing your PMP in first attempt. You cleared PMP exam with 5 above target. The best thing that anyone can do. 5 above target. Ladies and gentlemen, second student in 3 days, 5 above target.
I didn't expect that I will get this result. I thought that I will be like target or like above target.
Thanks to you. Without your dedication and gallants, it was impossible for me.
Above target. Do I have to write some book? No. Like, whenever he heard, like, this guy have read 5 times some book. So many times, you always get confused and come back to me. I kept on saying him, you are going to clear, just read one time. And that's what he did.
So here we have a certified PMP. Najam cleared PMP exam. Najam, when you cleared PMP exam?
Today. 2 o'clock.
At 2 o'clock, I would say, Saudi Arabia time, and it's almost 7 o'clock in Saudi Arabia. So just 5 hours ago, Najam became certified project management professional. So Najam, can you share us your journey, how you became PMP?
Yes, actually I started my preparation in the start of February. It was the first week of February, and I started with PM Box 6.
Okay.
And I just started going through it. And after one or two chapters, I thought I'm going nowhere. I was not able to understand it. It was too tough for me to understand. So then I had to look for the resources. I looked for Hellman's book. I looked for Rita's book. And finally, Rita, 10th edition was the one which I thought is very easy for a new beginner to understand.
Okay.
Book is talking to you. So it's easy for us to perceive the information. And then I just read it once completely. But then it's like an iteration. You have to go and read again and again, again and again. You're doing questions and then you see, oh, I missed that concept. So you go again and again. So I went through Rita several times, but I think that PM Box is very good for terminologies. If you have to understand definitions and references, then I refer to PM Box 6. That was also my key guide. And then after the Rita book, I need to do my 35 contact hours. I opted for Joseph Phillips. And I think his lectures were also very good. And always there was one thing I was doing, that was YouTube videos. I was, any problem I have, difference between risk register and risk report, YouTube video. Difference between OPUs and EEFs, YouTube video. And your coaching calls especially were very, very useful. The question and answers and the way you explained them really cleared a lot of concepts. So, and then it took me around 2.5 months. Actually, I was planning to give my exam after Eid, 22nd of May, somewhere in the mid of May. But we have only one center in Riyadh. The next date was in July. So I don't want to delay it because it was so much studying. I want to just get rid of it. So I checked. Luckily, the day was, I booked the exam one day before. And I was not mentally prepared for it, but I had to take the option because the next date was in July. So I took the risk and I backed up myself that I am prepared well, because I was doing a lot of questions and quizzes all along my preparation.
Okay. So which mocks in addition to Rita? Yeah. First of all, I would like to second what you just said. PMBOK is basically project management body of knowledge. It is more like a dictionary. It is more like a reference guide. It is not meant to be as a preparation guide. Yes, Rita has a good book. Yes, Kim has a good book. Scott has a good book. Andy Crow book is good. So there are various ways, whatever suits a person. So Rita suits you, good for you. You did the questions of Rita. Then you said, in addition to my coaching call, what other mocks you did?
You know what? I just purchased PM Prepcast 5 days ago.
Okay.
And I didn't do a single mock-up. mock-up, I had no time because just 2 days ago I booked my application for exam and I had still class with me and I was not able to do any mock-up. And the first mock-up I did was the PMP exam.
So my first mock-up. Just to put it in the reference, you have not done any complete mock.
No.
The Joseph Philip provide the one mock at the end of his course. You have not done the complete one of that?
That is 90 questions only. There is one 90 that I have done.
90.
But not the one.
No.
That is the 90 questions. Yeah, that I passed. I passed with 80% or 85%, both of them.
Okay.
So full 180 questions. And I think I had made some notes here, which will be very good as lessons learned from my experience. Time management is very important. I didn't have to do the mock-up, but if you have a chance, go for it. Because the first 60 questions I did in 85 minutes. And I was calculating the time exactly I am getting late. The next 60, I had to rush. I did in 66 minutes. So I saved my 10 minutes there.
Good.
And the last one, 78 minutes. So, and that was more than enough for me. I was left with 2-3 minutes. And there is one key thing, there is no time to revise. I have many certifications. I've done like 4 or 5 certifications before the PMP. And they are different programs, Green Building Council. And you can get time to review in those certifications. In PMP, you can't have any time to review the questions. Hardly you can flag 2, 3, 4 questions, not more than this, because really time management is very critical. And there is one thing, I was really clueless in the exam. I don't know what to do. In agile process, we talk about product owner prioritizing the backlog throughout. In all the questions in Agile, there was no mention of product owner. Project manager is the center of the universe. And the best thing is, out of the four options, the best one was prioritize the backlog. And the option was, what will the project manager do? There was nothing about the product owner. So I was really thinking, this is the responsibility of the product owner to backlog and to manage these things. But I had no option but to select that prioritize the backlog, because there was no product owner. So the product manager was doing that. Otherwise, all three options were going nowhere.
Means you utilized one of the principles of solving any MCQs, elimination technique.
Yes.
Eliminated the option, and whatever remained, you put it there. So just
absolutely right.
In the context, since in Agile, we don't have a project manager, we consider Scrum Master as a project manager. Scrum Master is not equivalent to PMP project manager. He has the responsibility of the project manager, but when we say the project manager, he can be Scrum Master as well as product owner. So that was a thing that basically reflected in your questions. Okay, what other lesson learns you can share with us?
Yes, I think when I got my application approved like a week ago or 10 days ago, I wrote that I am from the construction field. So I wrote predictive, I selected predictive. So I think my exam was more towards predictive. I just see so many videos, people saying there are 70% agile, 60% agile, but I think it was for me, maybe more than 50% predictive. And it was really crucial to know which process you are in. And the majority of the questions were from the execution phase. Implementing. There were from planning and initiating and controlling, but the majority of the questions I remember are from the implementing execution. And then there are some things which I would like to share, which I can recall now. There were questions about the leadership style for the project manager. There were questions about conflict management. There were questions about the risk types, avoid, mitigate, transfer. They were drag and drop questions. I think there were a lot of.
How many drags and drop?
There were around, I think, 10, 8 to 10 drag and drop. And they had each of them 4 to 5 options. They had 4 to 5 options, each of them. So, and I think one of them was out of the course, to be honest. I have never heard about it. And the rest, I knew, so I did it about the sprint and about the risk process. You have to match the risk processes.
Okay. So important thing I would like to know, you were able to manage that, like in your opinion, what you are saying, that when you are filling your application, that can have effect on your real exam.
I think so, yeah, because I put predictive as my main development approach.
I cannot accept it or and I cannot deny it because I don't have, but many of my students are going to give exam in upcoming, basically my batch is starting tomorrow, a new batch. So yes. I'm going to assist them in filling the application. So let's see.
Yes.
I will assist, we can put an experiment on that. People coming from—
This is just my perception because I think more predictive.
We can—
I mean, not more predictive, but it was maybe less agile. Maybe it was less agile, not as agile as I'm looking in the YouTube videos, everybody saying 70% agile, 60%. No. For me, it was more predictive. And you need to know the processes. I mean, not the ITTOs specifically, but the process. You need to understand which process are you in and what will be your available best option. And then all the questions were scenario based, 80% of them scenario based.
That is forgiven. But that thing is a very game changer. Like if a person is from IT, we can fill their application according to the IT point of view. If the person is—
yes.
We can, but the thing is that, you know, in my opinion, the exam of agile perspective is comparatively easier as compared to the exam of predictive perspective. Why?
I agree.
But you are saying knowing each process is actually a difficult thing. You have 49 process, and although I recommend for doing it for all the questions, but it becomes difficult. But we can check this perspective. Okay. Any other lesson learned you can share with us?
Yes, I think there were some questions from also from the organization point of view, organizational strategies, portfolio and program management. There were some questions that they're also about. And then there were a lot of questions. What will the project manager do next? I mean, first thing he will do.
Okay, so, if you have done the mocks, if you had done any mocks, that is basically the syntax. Yeah. Of the project, what the project manager should do first, what should the project manager do last. So that's
do next, yes.
Yes, that is the syntax of the PMP. Okay. And
I think the same concept, the servant leadership is very, very important. And the agile principles. You need to know the 12 principles. So you understand the philosophy of the agile.
Okay.
And questions, I prepared a lot about the feature development. XP, and there were questions from Kanban. There were questions from Burndown Chart. There was a hotspot question. I had need to pick the area about the story points from the Burndown Chart.
Okay.
And
first, I would say that you are the first student who had a hotspot question. So that's something new. Okay. And
there were 10 drag and drop questions. You need to understand the leadership styles, the risk strategies, the conflict management strategies, and like the motivations, the motivational strategies, and those in the resource chapter.
Mm-hmm.
And how to, the most of the cases were that the company is transitioning from predictive to agile. So what will be the case there? These were most of them were like—
Have you read Agile Guide?
Yes. I have read Agile Guide, the Scrum.
All those questions are actually answered in the Agile Guide.
yes. And I think you are right. The Agile part is comparatively easy. It's easy to understand because the philosophy is not complex. And if you understand the sprint, the processes of sprint, the artifacts, it's easy to gain the information.
Okay.
The process groups in the PM book. Yeah. So
it's far easier. It's far easier. Okay. Yes. Any other lesson learned, Najam, you have for us?
That's what I recall. So
okay. Thank you very much. You have given us your time, and especially on the day of the exam when you want to celebrate after iftari, you want to go somewhere. But I will say that COVID is so much, so don't go anywhere.
Yes.
This is my, I always ask at the end of the interview, what one advice you will give to all PMP aspirants? One.
Don't memorize, understand the concepts. Understand the concepts.
Loved it. 100% Rose. Don't memorize.
You have to understand the concept.
Understand the concept. Thank you, Najam. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. It was a pleasure learning from your videos, also your coaching calls. And then some other YouTube, there are teachers also, but your coaching calls with question and answers were very good. keep it up. I am really thankful to you.